Hi, I'm Bryan from Arturia, and in this video we'll be looking at the synth engine of Pigments in closer detail. The engine section of Pigments occupies the upper left area of the interface. Pigments contains two discrete synth engines. These can be selected by clicking in the tab areas and activated or disabled using the power icon. Each sound engine has two modes, analog and wavetable. The type of mode can be selected using the menu on the tab. Let's take a look at the analog engine. Here we have one of Pigments' engines in its virtual analog mode. Starting on the left, you'll see the tuning section, which contains a few simple but important parameters. The coarse tune knob affects the overall tuning of the engine. This can be quantized using the Q button and automated using modulations. We'll cover this in another video. You will also find a fine tuning knob for tuning in smaller increments and a drift knob. Increasing drift will add a random element to the pitch of each voice every time it's triggered. This is useful for adding neutral chorus to unison voices and width to chords. Now let's take a look at the oscillators. Each of the three oscillators can generate one of four waveforms: sine, triangle, saw, or wave. The width knob lets you alter the pulse width of the triangle and square wave, altering their tone, while the volume lets you adjust the level of each oscillator. All three oscillators feature a modulatable coarse tune knob, and oscillators 2 and 3 feature a fine tune parameter too. This has loads of applications, one of the simplest being manually creating intervals between each voice. The key switches on oscillator 2 and 3 make the oscillator follow the keyboard, or stay at a preset pitch, which can then be modulated. The sync switch forces the frequency of oscillator 2 to match oscillator 1, which can create some really interesting tones when they are tuned differently. On the right side of the analog engine, you'll spot the noise controls. You can add controlled noise to your analog sound chain with the volume knob, and control the type of noise with the source knob, from red through pink to white and blue. Now, if we take a look at the frequency modulation area below, you can see that you can modulate oscillators 1 and 2 by either the noise we just selected or by oscillator 3. You sweep this to find the perfect spot, or obviously modulate it. The amount can be controlled with a dedicated knob. Finally, the output sections lets you choose how much of the signal you want to send through filter 1 or filter 2, and the overall volume of the output. Pushing the volume too high will cause Pigments to clip, but it will do so with the same flavor of a vintage hardware synth. You may want to integrate this aggressive tone into your sound design. Now we've covered the analog engine, let's switch over to the wavetable engine. The wavetable oscillator creates the basis of your synth sound from snapshots of audio. The tune and output sections of the wavetable engine are similar to those found in the analog engine, so we'll skip these and get straight to the oscillator. Pigments comes with over 100 wavetables for you to experiment with. you can browse and select wavetables by clicking on the name at the top left. You can also import your own WAV files to create personalized wavetables. Hit the waveform button, select an audio file, and you're done. Once you've selected a wavetable, you can view it in either 2D or 3D in the waveform display. You can use the position knob to scan the wavetable to find the right one. You can do this in static snapshots or enable morphing with a morph button for more fluid selection. Again, all these parameters can be modulated in almost infinite ways, but we'll cover this in another video. Beneath the waveform view, you'll see four wave shaping parameters that can alter your sound in many different ways. These include frequency modulation, phase modulation, phase distortion, and wave folding. The modulator on the right-hand side acts as the source for these four wave shapers and can be dialed in to suit your patch. By experimenting and trusting your ear, you can go from really subtle effects to absolutely chaotic noise. It's up to you. This modulator can be set to one of 10 different types of wave and tuned as you want. You can also use the dedicated volume knob to introduce the modulator directly into the sound. This is a great way to add noise to your patch. The wavetable engine also features unison options. In classic mode, you can select how many voices you'd like the oscillator to generate, the tuning variation of each voice, and their stereo width. In chord mode, you can still choose the voices and stereo width, but you're given the option of forcing the voices into predefined chords. A variety of major, minor, sus, and octave options are available. Finally, if you wanted to duplicate an engine, there's a handy copy-paste button next to the Engine 1 and Engine 2 tab titles. And that covers the synth engines of Arturia Pigments. Remember, if you're ever not sure what a particular parameter does, hover your mouse over it and you should see a description at the bottom of the interface. In the next episode, we'll cover the filters and effects of this powerful software synth. See you next time.